Hi, let's talk about the superficial features of the face. Probably the most succinct way of describing the face is that it's a collection of fissures or openings. So we have palpebral fissures for the eyes, we have nares for the nose, and we have the oral fissure for the mouth. Now regarding these, if we start with the palpebral fissures, the palpebrae are actually the eyelids. So there's a superior and an inferior palpebra. And then for each eye, there is a medial and lateral canthus. For the mouth, there's something analogous where we have angles of the mouth. And those angles of the mouth are controlled by the modioli. So the modiolus is an interdigitation of fibromuscular tissue where muscles of facial expression are coming together. So for instance, when some of the elevators of the upper lip pull the modiolus superiorly and perhaps even a little laterally, then there's a smile. If we pull that modiolus inferiorly and laterally, then we have a frown. If we pull that modiolus laterally, then we have a smirk. Regarding the nose, laterally surrounding the nares is the ala of the nose. Ala means wing. Within the nose, there's also a nasal septum, and that nasal septum has a terminus, an inferior part here, called the nasal columella. So that nasal columella is going to be contiguous with that septal cartilage, and it's covered with skin. Below the nasal columella is a divot just above the superior lip called the philtrum. And then finally, we have a few folds to discuss. So there are the nasolabial folds. So these nasolabial folds go out laterally like so. And then we have a mentolabial fold, so between the mental region and the lips there. So as you can see, the nasolabial folds and the mentolabial folds are going to surround the oral fissure. So these are just some of the superficial features of the face that you ought to keep in mind when considering both the deeper structures and how the face may move and react in response to the contraction of various facial muscles. Thank you very much for your time.